Yeah, hi there, Fahad. This is Michael. I'm the founder, owner, and the materials writer of Your Lessons at Stealth, the seven-step system to pass TOEFL IVT. You just completed a independent speaking practice test. You're one of my California State University students, and I want to go ahead and listen to it right now. So let's hear what you had to say. Go ahead and open it up right now. Here we go.
Hello, Mike. This is Fahad Assadeh, one of your students in TOEFL class, in San Bernardino University.
All right, thank you for recording your response.
To answer your question, the best place that I have ever visited is San Diego. It has many attractions where you can entertain, enjoy, and spend time with your family and friends either.
Now be careful here. Remember, the first part of the question is describe a place you visited as a child. So if you talk about San Diego, you can't just talk about San Diego generally. You need to focus around some specific area. For example, you might talk about going to La Jolla Beach in San Diego or going to an amusement park in San Diego, or you know, going to Old Town to a Mexican restaurant in San Diego. So you need to be a little bit more specific in your ideas.
San Diego has two different lifestyles. It has the morning. In the morning, I mean, the city is one of the best cities in the world.
So you're at 52 seconds and you're still not giving any details. You need to be much, much, much more specific in your answer.
That has a fabulous beaches, and one of them is a Pacific beach. Of course, there are many beaches in the city, but I want to emphasize these beaches because I visited it, so I know where the location is.
Okay, so you're getting to the beach, which is good. That's more limiting, and that's going to help focus your ideas. And you now want to describe it, but you're taking too long to get to your details.
And many surfers go to the beach, do their sport, while others like to go and do scuba diving and sport. In evening lifestyle, I would suggest you to go to
Now, wait a minute. Now, you're talking about what people can do. I would suggest that you can do when you go. You're not really telling people what they can do in San Diego. You want to focus around describing some part of San Diego and then explaining what your favorite memory is. So your speech is going away from the purpose. You're not really directly answering the question.
It has many bars and nice clubs where you and your friends can.
So you said, you know, it has clubs and things where you can. I would focus more around what did you do when you were in San Diego? You're not really giving instructions on what a tourist can do when he or she goes to San Diego. You're focusing around describing a place and then explaining what your favorite memory is while visiting that place.
I would suggest you to go over there at night. By the way, it's a secured area. So in conclusion, San Diego City is the best city I have ever visited due to the variety of entertainment that it has.
All right, so you spoke for 2 minutes and 10 seconds. You want to try to get this down to about 45 seconds, and you need a lot more detail. So the second part of the question is, what is your favorite memory while visiting the place? I don't really think you answered that part of the question either. So describing the place, your answer was too broad. What is your favorite memory? You didn't really directly address that. So how would you score on this particular practice test? So let's take a look at the rubrics for just a minute. On this one, you probably score, I'm guessing, right around 2.0 out of 4, or 15 points out of 30. Now, they help you organize a little bit better. I have a good lesson that I think will help you, two different lessons. Number one is speaking lesson number two. The first 5 minutes of the video will show you how to create a more specific topic statement. Also, speaking lesson number seven, I think is important for you too, because it'll show you four different things you can do to organize your ideas better than what you're doing right now. So I'd recommend you review both of those lessons. Now for pronunciation, take a look at my pronunciation lessons focusing on intonation. That's the second section of my course. I have five specific lessons on intonation. I think you could also benefit by reviewing and learning the information in those lessons. All right, anyway, Fahad, thank you for completing the practice test, and I look forward to hearing from you again when you do the final exam.